All right, guys, today we're going to take a look at the OTOFIX BT1 Lite battery tester. It's made by OTOFIX, but OTOFIX is owned by Autel. They make the same device in Autel branded colors, and it's called the Autel BT506. I'm making this video while also making the video for the OTOFIX D1 Lite scan tool, and I wanted to make a separate video about the battery tester. So this battery tester is designed to work with a tablet with the battery tester software already installed, or you can download the Autel battery tester app from the App Store onto an Android phone. And sorry for the Apple users, I'd have to check. I'm not an Apple user, but I assume it would also work on Apple devices. But you just download the app. It's a free download as long as you buy the device. So you can use this with either your OTOFIX or your Autel branded scan tool. And I have an Autel 808 that I'm going to verify this with later in the video. Right now we're going to go into the battery test software on the OTOFIX D1 Lite. All right, so it's just as easy as connecting the black and red battery clamps. The OTOFIX battery tester has a blue status light, which means it's connected to the tablet, and it has a power light, meaning that it has power. The battery tester itself does have a battery inside, so that when you disconnect the cables, you can turn it back off with this push-button power switch. When I received this tester from Amazon, the battery inside didn't have any power in it. But as soon as I connected it to an electrical system, then the battery inside here was able to charge. And then when I disconnected the cables, the first time I tried it, I had to turn the device off here with the power switch. But that's just all it is out here, is just connected to the battery like you would normal, and then we'll go inside and continue with the test. Okay, so we'll go into in-vehicle test. There's a disclaimer. We're going to go in like we have not tested it previously. It's decoding the VIN. It gives us the information that's... Now it's doing this, it's pulling up the vehicle information through the data link connector. So this scan tool is not only connected to the battery via the battery tester, but it also has the VLC data link connector, the standard OBD2 dongle that the scan tool uses is connected to the DLC port under the dash, and that's where it's getting this information. However, my truck has a little bit different battery in it, so we'll go in and we'll change that. Mine is a flooded, it's an 800 cold cranking amp for northern climates. And the rest of it's correct. We'll hit next. It says turn off electrical appliances, ignition off, and close all the doors. So we'll check all those check boxes saying that that's been done. We'll click start testing. Now it's going to test the battery with nothing going on. All right, now we'll continue. Now we're going to do the starter test. It says ensure the ignition is off. Checkbox. Start testing. Waiting for the vehicle to start. All right, here we go. Okay. Then we'll hit continue. It says turn off electrical appliances such as headlamps and air conditioning and press continue. Everything is already off, so we'll press continue. It says keep the engine speed at 2 to 3,000 RPM and press continue. Now, because this is connected through the data link connector, and you may not get this if you're using it with your smartphone without the data link connector connected, this thing knows my engine RPM on this graph. However, it's not exactly 100% accurate. So I'm looking at my tachometer right now, and I'm at 2,000 just now, and this is showing just a hair under. But I'm going to hit continue. Release accelerator pedal and press continue. All right. Turn on electrical appliances such as headlamps, AC, and press continue. All right. Turn on all that stuff, headlamps, blower, continue, keep the engine at 2 to 3,000, Continue. Release accelerator and press continue. Continue. Oh, maybe I didn't get it. There we go. Turn off the ignition and electrical appliances. Press continue. Continue. So, here's the report. Now, you know this is owned by Autel when the Autofix battery tester on the Autofix scan tool comes up with Autel branded battery report. But it'll if you can scroll down, it shows the battery voltage, state of charge, the temperature, cranking voltage, charging normally. Gives you all sorts of stuff. You can add into your shop name and address and your customer information. And then now we're going to save this. If your scan tool currently has an internet connection, you can email it or share it via the cloud. And that's pretty handy because if you share it via the cloud, it'll come up with a QR code that you can, like say you had a customer or even your own cell phone, you could scan the QR code on the screen of the scan tool, or you could have your customer scan the QR code on the screen of your cell phone, and it would automatically pop this battery report up on the screen of their smart device. But I don't have an internet connection at the moment, so we're just going to hit save, and it's creating a PDF, and we'll go to the view to PDF report. And again, it's Autel branded battery report, so it shows you some graphs. It's got the information. Here's the cranking, the charging. And like I say, you can add, you know, customer information and date and address and shop information. And then just to show you, when I was doing this before on a different car, here, this black and white, but I blocked it out. But the QR code will pop up if you share it via QR code. It'll pop up on here with the QR code, and then you can just scan that. It'll pop up on the screen of whatever smart device you scanned it with. So that's pretty cool. It's a pretty darn neat device. And then if we back out of this, completely back out of it, and then it's a reminder to take the, if you go to Data Manager, if you go over here to Cloud Report, here's the Cloud Report that we just did. Now, if you look down here, there's a share symbol and a share symbol. These are earlier tests when I was playing with the device earlier, and at that time, the scan tool did have an internet connection. Now, today when I'm doing it for filming purposes, I'm away from a Wi-Fi connection, so I do not have the share option. But if you did have it connected to Wi-Fi, you would be able to share it via the cloud or email or whatever your choice may be. But there's the report that we just created. So that battery tester is pretty slick. It's a neat device. It does work with your cell phone. You can download the app. Like I say, it doesn't automatically populate some information because you're not using it in conjunction with your VLC connector like you normally have with the scan tool. But it does work pretty good, and it gives you an idea of where you're at with your, you know, whether it would be your own battery or a customer battery, or, you know, it gives you an idea. Now, granted, it does not no electronic battery testing equipment will replace a true carbon pile load tester. You know, that's the real way to test a battery, but those things are big, heavy, and expensive. So unless you're doing it every day, all day for a living, you know, you may not be interested in investing in a large carbon pile device. Okay, guys, real quick, I almost forgot. Before we end the video, I was going to show you that this Autofix BT1 Lite battery tester works with the Autel scan tool. And so, first of all, what I'm going to show you here is that it's connected via Bluetooth. So if we go into the VCI manager, and this is true with the Autofix scan tool also. This is the same between an Autofix or an Autel. If you go into the VCI manager here, it'll show that my VCI is connected via Bluetooth, and it'll also show that the battery tester is connected via Bluetooth. And then if you wanted to connect them via wire, you know, on the back of these Bluetooth dongles, there's a connection that you can connect a wire to the scan tool. Then you would, these are the Bluetooth connections, and these are the wired connections. So if you plug in a cable, and connect it to the scan tool via a cable. It automatically disconnects the Bluetooth connection and then connects it wired, and it would say connected and connected. And just for example, say you're trying to connect, you know, set up your battery tester and connect it, and you're sitting on this screen going, well, God, I can't get it connected. Well, sometimes you have to press the device itself and it'll start pairing. You know, you could sit there for quite a while waiting for it to pair, and nothing's happening. And same with the VCI, whether it's the VCI for your OBD2 data or it's the battery tester itself. Whatever it may be, as soon as you connect it the first time, whenever you connect it for the first time, it may appear on this screen. You know, it sees it, but you have to actually click on it to make it pair. Anyhow, so on this screen, you can see that they're both connected. And you could, from here, you could go to the battery tester software and you would run the battery test just like I showed you on the AutoFix scan tool. But anyway, from here, you would go into the battery tester software and pick your test and go ahead and start your test just like we did on the other AutoFix scan tool. I won't really talk about dollar amounts because videos stay on the internet forever and prices can change daily, but I will tell you that when I bought that BT1 Lite battery tester, which I paid for with my own money, and I ordered it from Amazon, the BT1 Lite, it was less than one quarter of the price than it was in the Autel branded version, the black and red instead of the black and orange. Now, I don't know what the price is today. Maybe it's gone back up. Maybe I got a certain special on the deal. I don't know. I just went on Amazon, searched for it, and bought it. So check it out. It'd be nice to know that if you wanted a battery tester to use with your Autel scan tool, you can maybe save a few dollars that way. That's all I have for now. Please be sure to like, share, and subscribe for more. Thanks for watching.